So good morning all. Myself Manoj Kumar Gundela, Assistant Professor Suresh Gyan Vihar University Jaipur. So last class we discussed about the cucurbits. So in cucurbits the next crop is bottle gourd. So bottle gourd, the botanical name is Legionaria cicinaria. Family Cucurbitaceae. It is a monoecious plant. Monoecious, male and females are present in different flowers. And it is a day neutral plant. It is a day neutral plant. The isolation distance for foundation seed is 800 meters and for certified seed is 400 meters. 2N is equal to 22. Origin is South Africa. Bottle gourd or calabas is a delicately flavored. The cucurbita family vegetables. It is one of the chief culinary vegetable in many tropical and temperate regions around the world. The bottle gourd is a fast growing annual climber vine that requires adequate sunlight for flowering and fruiting. It can be grown under the wide range of soil and requires drills into support and spread. Its intensely branched stem bears the musky deep green or broad leaves, just similar as the pumpkins, as white or monoecious flowers in summer. After about 75 days from the plantation, young, tender, edible fruits involved that will be ready for harvesting. Bottle gourd comes in wide ranges of shape and size. The fruit features are ovule, pear-shaped, elongated, and smooth skin. This is light green in color. In case of round or the pear-shaped calabas, their surface is marked by inconspicuous ridges that run lengthwise. Internally, its flesh is white, spongy, and amended with soft, tiny seeds. The fruits are used as a vegetable and making the sweets like halwa, kheera, petha, barfi, and pickles. As a vegetable, it is easily digestible even by the patients. The dry, hard shell are used for making the musical instruments, pipe, bowls, bottles, containers, floats, fishing nets, and kofta is the most popular preparation. Good source of fibers, fiber-free carbohydrates, root pericarp and crude fibers. Oil extracted from kernels and the seed is used as a hair oil. Climate and soil. It requires a loamy or sandy loamy soil is most suitable. A too much acid soil pH is not suitable. If the pH is less than 5.5, it is not suitable. Seed germination, the temperature is 25 to 30 degrees centigrade temperature is required. The night temperature is 18 to 22 degrees centigrade and day temperature is 30 to 35 degrees centigrade is optimum. Day temperature is above 40 may cause the scorching of the leaves. If the temperature is 30 to 35 is maximum temperature. If the temperature is more than 40, it causes the scorching of the leaves. The optimum temperature has the higher proportion of female flowers and fruit per plant. The higher temperature induces the maleness. If the temperature is more, then it will induce the maleness. It is grown in summer and rainy season. In summer, the crop is sown in December, January, and in rainy season, it is sown in June, July. Varieties Arka Bahar. Kalyanpur Hari Lambi. The fruits are slightly dark green in color. NDBG1 gives the early yield in upland condition. Highly preferred for the Daira cultivation. NDBG4, PBOG1, Pule BTG1 produce the comparatively more female flowers at a basal nodes. Punjab Komal variety with shortest duration from fruits to maturity. It will take only 70 डेज फॉर फ्रूट्स टू द मेच्योरिटी. पंजाब लौंग, पंजाब राउंड, पंजाब पूषा मंजरी. इट इज ए हाई यील्डिंग हाइब्रिड राउंड फ्रूटेड. पूषा मेघदूत. इट इज ए F1 हाइब्रिड बिटवीन द पूषा समर प्रोलिफिक लौंग एंड सिलेक्शन टू. पूषा मेघदूत F1 हाइब्रिड बिटवीन द पूषा समर प्रोलिफिक लौंग एंड सिलेक्शन टू. पूषा नवीन परफेक्टली सिलेंड्रिकल फ्रूट्स फ्री फ्रॉम क्रुक नेक. पूषा समर प्रोलिफिक लौंग कैन बी ग्रोन इन रेनी सीजन ऑल्सो. पूषा समर प्रोलिफिक राउंड प्रोलिफिक बियर्स एंड हैवी यील्डर्स. राजेंद्र चमत्कार. कल्याणपुर लॉन्ग ग्रीन. इट इज डेवलप्ड बाई CSAU ATV वेजिटेबल्स रिसर्च स्टेशन कल्याणपुर कानपुर. चंद्रशेखर आजाद वेजिटेबल्स इन कानपुर. सम्राट. इट इज रिलीज फ्रॉम महात्मा फूले कृषि विद्यापीठ राहुल. इट इज मेनली यूज फॉर द बॉक्स पैकिंग. हाइब्रिड पूसा हाइब्रिड 3 फॉर. इट इज मेनली यूज फॉर द डिस्टेंस मार्केट वेरी अर्ली मैच्योरिंग. आनंद BG1 जूनागढ़ लॉन्ग टेंडर. सीड रेट 3 to 3.5 kg पर हेक्टेयर सीड रेट और 400 to 500 सीड्स पर 100 ग्राम. 3 to 3.5 kg पर हेक्टेयर सीड रेट एंड 450 to 500 सीड्स पर हेक्टेयर इज पर 100 ग्राम इज रिक्वायर्ड. स्पेसिंग इज 2 into 1 meter. आफ्टर जर्मिनेशन द वाइन्स में बी ट्रेंड ऑन द बोवर सिस्टम. 20 टन पर हेक्टेयर FIM along with 150-50 kg of NPK is to be applied. The first half dose of nitrogen must be applied and the basal dose, while the other half dose of nitrogen we apply 30 days after sowing. The crop requires frequent irrigation as high humidity is needed for the prolific bearing. During the hot and humid weather, the irrigation after every third or fourth day is needed. Fruit set can be improved by spraying the plants with malic hydrazide 400 ppm along with 100 kg of nitrogen per hectare. To improve the fruit set, what we have to do? We use the malic hydrazide 400 ppm along with the 100 kg nitrogen per hectare. So nitrogen is always applied in split dose. We don't apply the nitrogen, complete dose of nitrogen at a time, because due to the two types of losses are there. One is leaching loss is there, second one is denitrification losses is there. The crop is ready to harvest approximately 60 to 70 days after sowing. The fruits take 12 to 15 days after fruit setting to reach the marketable stage. The fruit should be picked after every 3 to 4 days. The smaller and tender fruits fetches a better price in the market. The crop are ready for harvesting 60 to 70 days after sowing, and fruits take 12 to 15 days for the fruit setting. Every 3 to 4 days, a smaller and tender fruit fetches a better price in the market. The total yield is 20 ton per hectare, and for hybrid it is 40 to 50 ton per hectare. Next crop is bitter gourd. Bitter gourd, it is also called as balsam pear, bitter cucumber, or bitter melon. Mormodica chalensia. The family is Cucurbitaceae, 2N is equal to 22. It is originated from Indo-Burma. Grow for its tender fruits, turns to the orange-yellow color when ripe. Certain effective against the diabetes. With bitter gourd, the mormodin is present. Certain is present. It is effective for the diabetes. Monoecious in nature, fresh to dehydrated fruit ratio is 16:1. The bitter principle is mormedicine. Mormedicine is a bitter principle, rich source of iron. Climate and soil. It is a warm season crop. The optimum temperature is 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. The temperature is less than 18 degrees centigrade, low the growth, poor yield, and 36 degrees centigrade reduction in the female flowers. If temperature less than 18 degrees centigrade, slow the growth, poor the yield. And if temperature 36 degrees centigrade reduction in the female flowers. The long days, the male flowers will develop. The low temperature 20 degrees centigrade and short day, the female flowers will develop. The long days are there. Long days means the male flowers will develop. If the temperature is less and shorter days, the female flowers will develop. The temperature is less than 18 degree, slow growth, poor yield. If the temperature is more than 36, reduction in the female flowers. If the temperature is more, the female flowers will be reduced. Sandy loamy soils are most suitable. The pH is 6.5 to 7 is more suitable for growing of this beetle gourd. Sowing. July, September and January, February is the best time for the sowing. The seed rate is 4 to 5 kg per hectare seed rate we use. Seed treatment. Normally seed treatment is thyrone, we use 2 gram per kg of seeds. The 4 seeds per pit are sown under lateral 2 to 3 may be retained. Instead of sowing in the main field, the seeds can be sown in polythene bags and can be shifted to the pits in the main field after 15 to 20 days. 4 seeds per pit are sown and later 2 to 3 may be retained. The instead of sowing in main field, the seeds may be sown in polythene bags and can be shifted to the pits in the main field. Means first we sow the seeds into the polythene bag, then we shift into the main field. That is the better method. Or directly we can sow the seeds. Spacing is 2 into 1.5 meters. The crops will be irrigated immediately after planting in summer and subsequently 2 to 3 days interval. Means directly after transplanting we have to irrigate, then 2 to 3 days interval we have to go for irrigation. Varieties. Pusa Do Mousmi. It is grown well in summer as well as in rainy season. Pusa Do Mousmi is grown well in summer as well as in the rainy season. Pride of Surat, Pride of Gujarat, Arka Harit, Pusa Vishesh, suitable for summer season, Pule Green, MPKV Rahuri, Pule Green Gold, Priya 40 cm long fruits, Kirti white in color, Kalyanpur Shona, stuffing, Priyanka white in color, Coimbatore long white extra long fruits, Pusa Hybrid 1 or 2, Pusa Hybrid 1 and Pusa Hybrid 2, Konkan Tara export quality. It is from Konkan Krishi Vidyapeeth, Dapoli, Maharashtra. MDU 1, it is induced mutant, greenish white and spiny fruits. Coimbatore Green, extra long fruits up to 60 cm. Harkani from MPKV Rahuri, RHR BGH 1 or MPKV Rahuri. F1 hybrid stolen to downy mildew. 20 ton per hectare FIM 60-60-60 NPK reapply kg per hectare of NPK reapply. Application of growth regulators 2 to 4 leaf stage play an important role in sex expression and sex ratio. Normally we apply the growth regulator 2 to 4 leaf stage, so it will play an important role in sex expression and sex ratio. Malic hydrazide 50 to 150 ppm, TCC 50 to 100 ppm, it will increase the female to male ratio, means it will increase the female flowers. Ethrel 25 ppm increase the female flowers. If the ethrel 25 ppm, it will also increase the female flowers. Malic hydrazide 150 to 250 ppm, when applied at 2 leaf stages in Pusa Do Mousmi, it will induce the formation of female flowers. So normally the male flowers are more and female flowers are less. So we have to develop the more female flowers because we will get the fruits from the female flowers only. So what we have to do, the ratio is 1:10, means 1 female flowers and 10 male flowers are there. But we have to reduce that. Means we want to increase more female flowers. So what we have to do, we have to use the growth regulator at 2 to 4 leaf stage only. So in that, different growth regulators we use at the different rate of application. Like Ethrel 25 ppm we use, malic hydrazide 150 to 250 ppm we use, then malic hydrazide 150 to 150 ppm we use, CCC, Cycosil 50 to 100 ppm we will use, so that all will be increase the more female flowers as compared to the male flowers. Flowering time is 45 to 55 days after sowing. The first picking should be taken 60 to 70 days after planting. Means after 60 to 75 days after planting, we have to take the first picking. The yield is 10 to 15 ton per hectare. The फॉर हाइब्रिड द यील्ड इज 20 to 30 टन पर हेक्टेयर। नेक्स्ट क्रॉप इज दिस गार्ड लूपा एक्यूटिगुला। तो इट इज द फैमिली इज कुकरबिटेसी। क्रोमोजोम नंबर 2 n = 26। इट इज ए मोनोशेष। ओरिजन इज एशिया। इट कंटेन ल्यूफिन। इट कंटेन द ल्यूफिन कमर्शियली ट्रेंड एज नेफिन सिस्टम। नॉर्मली वी यूज द नेफिन सिस्टम ऑफ ट्रेनिंग इन दिस। द फ्रूट्स आर रिब्ड एंड कॉल्ड काली काली तोरी। फ्रूट्स आर रिब्ड एंड इट इज कॉल्ड एज काली तोरी। इट कंटेन 18 mg/100 g ऑफ विटामिन सी। द जीनस डेराइव्स इट्स नेम फ्रॉम द प्रोडक्ट ऑफ लुफास विच इज यूज इन बाथिंग स्पॉन्जेस स्क्रबलर बेड्स एंड डोरमेट्स पिलो मैटर्स। दीज आर ऑल आर प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम क्लाइमेट एंड सोइल। इट इज ग्रोन वेरी वेल इन वार्म हॉट क्लाइमेट। ऑप्टिमम टेम्परेचर इज 25 to 30 degrees centigrade। हायर टेम्परेचर मोर देन 38 degrees centigrade प्रोड्यूस द मेल फ्लावर्स। सैंडी लोमी सोइल रिच इन ऑर्गेनिक मैटर इज मोर सुटेबल। प्रॉपर ड्रेनेज इज हाईली बेनिफिशियल। द पीएच इज 6.5 to 7। सोइंग द टाइम ऑफ सोइंग इज जुलाई टू सेप्टेम्बर और जनवरी टू फरवरी। सीड दैट 3 to 5 kg per hectare। 3 to 5 kg per hectare स्पेसिंग 1.5 to 0.5 meter और 1.5 into 1 meter। सो द 4 seeds per pit रिटेन ओनली 2 healthy seedlings। 4 seeds per pit वी हैव टू सो एंड रिटेन ओनली 2 healthy seedlings। सीड कैन ऑल्सो बी रेस्ड इन पॉली बैग्स विच फर्दर रिड्यूस द सीड रेट ऑफ 1.5 kg per hectare। वेराइटीज पूसा नसदार। इट इज सुटेबल फॉर समर एंड रेनी सीजन। पूसा नसदार इज सुटेबल फॉर समर एंड रेनी सीजन। CO1 सात पुटिया। इट इज ए हर्मोपोडाइट। सात पुटिया हर्मोपोडाइट। स्मॉलर फ्रूट्स इन क्लस्टर्स पेल ग्रीन फ्रूट्स। स्मॉलर फ्रूट्स इन क्लस्टर्स पेल ग्रीन फ्रूट्स। सात पुटिया। कोंकण हरिता। इट इज डेवलप फ्रॉम कोंकण कृषि विद्यापीठ दापोली महाराष्ट्र। फर्स्ट हार्वेस्ट विल स्टार्ट 45 days आफ्टर प्लांटिंग। पंजाब सदाबहार रिच इन प्रोटीन। IISR 8। इट इज ए हाई यील्डिंग गुड मार्केट वैल्यू गुड कुकिंग क्वालिटी। PKM 1 पूसा सदाबहार हिसार काली तोरी गुजरात आनंद RG 1 पंत तोरई 1 अर्का सूरत अर्का सुजत अर्का सुमित स्वर्ण मंजरी स्वर्ण उपकार पूसा नूतन सुरेखा। दीज आर द इम्पोर्टेंट हाइब्रिड एंड वेराइटीज। FIM 2010 पर हेक्टेयर FIM वी अप्लाई 50 25 25 kg per hectare ऑफ NPK वी अप्लाई। हाफ डोज ऑफ नाइट्रोजन वी अप्लाई एज ए बेसल डोज एंड रिमेनिंग हाफ डोज वी अप्लाई 30 days आफ्टर प्लांटिंग। FIM 2010 पर हेक्टेयर नाइट्रोजन इन वी अप्लाई इन 2 split doses। फर्स्ट वी अप्लाई इनिशियल स्टेज एंड सेकेंड हाफ डोज वी अप्लाई 30 days आफ्टर प्लांटिंग। NAA we apply 200 ppm, it will help to maintain the sex ratio. Same problem, sex ratio is the major problem in this male to female ratio. So we have to maintain, take the more female flowers and less male flowers. So for that we have to apply the NAA. The crop is ready for harvesting in 60 to 90 days after planting. The fruits attain marketable maturity about 5 to 7 days after anthesis of the female flowers. The picking should be done after every 3 to 4 days. The average yield is 10 to 15 ton per hectare. The hybrids, it is 20 to 30 ton per hectare. Next is Pons Guard, Lupa cylindrica. Family Cucurbitaceae. Fruits are smooth and called ghia torai. It contains lupin. It contains lupin 2n is equal to 22, it is originated from Asia. Has the higher protein and carotene than the discard. It contains the higher quantity of protein and carotene than the discard. It is a monoecious. It is a monoecious plant. It is also called as tall gourd, smooth gourd, loofah, vegetable sponge, disc cloth gourd. So these are the different name of sponge gourd. Loofah cylindrica, cucurbitaceae family. Climate. It is grown well in warm, hot climate. Optimum temperature is 25 to 30 degrees centigrade. The higher temperature, more than 38 degrees centigrade, produces the male flower. If temperature will be optimum temperature is 25 to 30, if the temperature is more than 38 degrees centigrade, then the more male flowers will be developed. If more male flowers will be developed, then it is not good for the plant. We require more female flowers, not male flowers. Only female flowers will give the fruits. Male flowers will not give any fruits. So if 10 female flowers are there, 1 male flowers are there, that is sufficient. But if 10 male flowers and 1 female flowers are there, that is not good. Sandy loamy soil, this inorganic matter is more suitable. Proper drainage is highly beneficial. The pH is 6.5 to 7 and frost susceptible. Sowing. The time of sowing is July to September. Time of sowing is July to September and January to February. The seed rate is 3 to 5 kg per hectare. Seed rate 3 to 5 kg per hectare. Spacing is 1.5 to 0.5 meter or 1.5 to 1 meter. So sow the seeds, 4 seeds per pit. Normally we sow the 4 seeds per pit and retain 2 healthy seedlings. 4 seeds per pit we have to sow and we have to allow only 2 healthy seedlings to grow. For gap filling, we have to sow the seeds in polythene bags and then we have to go for transplanting into the main field. It will reduce the seed rate. So normally if we grow the seeds in polythene bags, then the seed rate will be 1.5 kg per hectare. And if we are grow the direct seed, then it is double, 3 to 5 kg per hectare. So that is the best. If we grow in polythene bags, and seedlings will also healthy in that. Varieties, Pusa Sneha, Pule, Priyanka, MKKV Rahuri, Kalyanpuri Hari, Chikni. Pusa Chikni, it is a high yielding, early maturing, bearing, flowering 45 days after sowing, summer and rainy season. Pusa Gujarat Galka, 1. Pusa Supriya, it is a summer and kharif improvement over the Pusa Chikni. Ready for first picking in 45 to 47 to 55 days after sowing. Pusa Supriya. Rajendra Nuna 1. So these all are the varieties. Then hybrid Harita, PGS 40, Divyanka, Azad Tarai 1, Azad Tarai 1, and Azad Tarai 2. So these are the hybrids. FIM 2010 per hectare along with 50-25-25 kg per hectare of NPK we apply. Half dose and basal dose and the other half dose of nitrogen. We miss nitrogen, we apply in two split dose. First dose we apply at initial stage and second half dose of nitrogen we apply 30 days after planting. FIM we apply 2010 per hectare and 50-25-25 NPK we apply. Ethrel 250 ppm, it will help to maintain the sex ratio, that male to female ratio will be maintained. The crop is ready for harvesting in about 60 to 90 days after planting. The fruit attain marketable maturity about 5 to 7 days after anthesis of female flowers. Means it will take 5 to 7 days for development of the fruits after anthesis. The picking should be done after 3 to 4 days. Picking should be done after 3 to 4 days and the time of picking is morning hours or evening hours. Hybrid 20 to 30 10 per hectare. The yield is 20 to 30 10 per hectare for hybrid, for the varieties 10 to 15 10 per hectare. Suchau, Tisium eduli. Family is Cucurbitaceae, 2N is equal to 24. It is originated from Mexico. Is a single seeded fruit. If anyone asks, the example of single seeded fruit is chow chow. The more nutritious among the cucurbits, the perennial climbing vine with tuberous roots is a monoecious high calcium content, also called chayota, choco, or ascus, propagated by fruits or viviparity. Viviparity means in fruits only the roots will develop in plants itself. So that is called as viviparity nature. Pear shaped fruit. The fruits are look like pear shaped. So chayota is, it is called as chayota, choco, or ascus. It is a high calcium content, monoecious, and propagation by fruits or viviparous pear shaped fruits. Fruits are look like pear shaped. Two tuber seeds leaves have been long used by the native of America. That means tubers also use, fruits also use, seeds also use, leaves also use. The seeds are even considered a delicacy. Varieties round white, long white, pointed green, broad green, oval green. In Bangalore, two type of green and creamy green are grown. It required well drained soil rich in organic matter. The pH is 5.5 to 6.5 pH. By spacing is 3.5 to 2 meter. It required a more spacing. Plant required support by poles or drills. We can use either, we can use poles to support the plant. 5.5 to 6.5 pH. Vines start flowering in 3 to 4 months and produce, and the production is continuous. The vine start flowering is 3 to 4 months. Means after 3 to 4 months, the flowering will be start, and then it will be continuous. The Bangalore, in Bangalore, the planting is done all around the year, but preferably in the July. Bangalore, the planting time is complete July. The single fruit weight is 250 to 450 gram. Means one fruit weight is 250 to 450 gram, and the total yield is 20 to 25 ton per hectare. So these are the major vegetables, major gourds that is comes under the cucurbitaceae family. That is chow chow, snake gourd, sponge gourd, pointed gourd. So these all are the gourds that is comes under the cucurbitaceae family. That's all about the today's class. Thank you, Oj. Thank you. Good morning all, myself Manoj Kumar Gundela, Assistant Professor, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. Today we will discuss the seed production technology of vegetable crop. In this, today we will discuss the vegetable seed production. So these are the different vegetables. In this, how we can go for seed production, that we will discuss in detail. Vegetable characteristics. Vegetable is early maturing and high yielding. It matures in 60 to 90 days after planting. Vegetable has a very high nutritive value. Vegetable has versatile of numbers of uses. Means they have so many numbers of uses. Diversity in kind and varieties of vegetables. Adaptability of vegetable in a wide range of soil and climatic condition. Means vegetables, they are grown in so many type of climatic conditions, and they will adapt to the different area of production. Difference between the open pollinated varieties and hybrid. The open pollinated seeds is being produced from the open pollinated varieties of vegetables can be planted from the next planting season. In open pollinated seeds is being produced from the open pollinated varieties of vegetables can be planted from the next planting season, provide the genetic purity in maintain and proper selection and production technology is applied. Means proper planting distance we have to maintain and proper genetic purity we have to maintain when we go for seed production in open pollinated varieties. In case of hybrid seeds, it is produced from the F1 parents. Since F1 hybrids it will prepared from the F1 parents, they are high yielding and early maturity. Hybrids are they are the, they will give the high yield and they are early maturity. Open pollinated varieties, they will not give the so much of yield and they will take more time for the maturation. If still planted or use 30 to 40% yield reduction, so it will give the more yield as compared to the open pollinated varieties. Means they will give the 30 to 40% more yield as compared to the open pollinated varieties. Hybrids will give the more yield and open pollinated varieties will give the less yield. And nutritional value of open pollinated varieties are less and hybrid is more. Kind of seeds. Seeds matured ovule with embryo or endosperm covering the seeds. Seeds normally we can say seeds are matured ovule with embryo. It contain the embryo and matured ovule. Cutting moringa and sweet potato we will use cutting as a planting material. Rhizomes we use in ginger and taro, we use the rhizomes, ginger, turmeric and taro. Bulb tubers in this like bulb, onion and garlic, we use the bulbs like these are the onion and garlic, the seeds is bulb. In suckers we use in banana and pineapple. So these are the different kind of seeds. They all are the seeds only, because whatever the planting material we are using for development of next generation, that is called as seeds. Seed technology, it involves the following. Crop production management practice. First is crop production management practice. So crop production, how we can go for crop production? That using of open pollinated seeds, we can use our open pollinated seeds. Regular field inspection. Regularly we will go to the field, we will check the field whether there is attack of any varieties, whether there is attack of any disease, or there is attack of any pest, or that it is performing well or not, there is a scarcity of water, or there is a lack of water, or everything we have to check. Pre-planting consultation. Before planting, we have to go for site selection. We have to select the farm. After that, we will check the farm history. Because if in that farm, if there is a tip, there is a, some in soil, the larvae, pupas, they are present inside the soil. And if we grow the crop, they will attack on that crop. That also we have to check. Soil and nutrient management, we have to check the nutritional status of the soil, whether the soil is fertile or not, and the nutrient content is available for the plants or not. Water source, means regularly we have to apply the water. And NSIC varieties, we have to select the varieties also. Application of biological nitrogen can be applied as a seed coat to enhance the growth and root development. We will apply the biological nitrogen to increase the growth, to enhance the growth and root development. Makes the plant resistant to the drought and pest attack, means they are resistant to the drought, biotic and abiotic stress, resistance from the pest and disease. Replace the 30 to 50 more nitrogen requirement. We will use the more nitrogen if required, we will replace it by the 30 to 50. Maintain the genetic purity, means genetic purity also we have to maintain. Seed selection before planting. So before planting into the main field, we have to go for selection of the seeds. So whatever seeds we have to select, it is uniform in size. The size of the seed is uniform. Uniform in color. The color of the seed is uniform. Free from the insect pest attack. There is no attack of any insect and pest. Free from the disease infection. So sometimes there are seed-borne disease that is present inside the seeds. So we have to select the seed that is free from the seed-borne disease. And the color is uniform, size is uniform, color is uniform. Because the small size seeds, they will contain the small size of embryo. Some seeds, they will not contain the embryo. Some seeds, they are cut. So that type seeds, we have to not select. Cultural practice. Land preparation. Proper cultivation should be applied by 2x plowing and harrowing. So proper cultivation should we have to apply. Proper plowing we have to do and harrowing we have to do. Fertilization refers to the fertilizer's requirement of the vegetable based on the soil analysis. Means we have to check the soil first. We will check the nutrient status of the soil. According to that, we have to apply the fertilizers according to the crop requirement also. We have to check the crop requirements also. According to that, we apply the fertilizer. Planting method. We can use a direct or indirect seedlings of vegetable seeds we can use. We can use a direct method or indirect method. We can use small seeds are planted indirect, while the big seeds are planted direct. If the small seeds are seed are there, then we plant directly. If the big seed are big size are there, then we plant in big seed. We have to direct planting, and small seeds we have to indirectly we have to plant. Means first we prepare the nursery, then we go for planting into the main field. Proper distance. Follow the proper distancing of each commodity. Means we have to maintain a proper spacing. Whenever we go for seed production, we have to maintain a proper spacing, because if we not maintain the proper spacing, if any cross-pollinated crop are there, then the pollens from the other crops will be fall down on that particular crop, and we will not maintain the purity in that. Weed management, shallow cultivation and hand weeding should be applied. Normally we will go for shallow cultivation, and hand weeding is best. Water management, during early stage of plant growth, development and summer time. So normally in summer time we have to apply the more quantity of water, in winter we have to apply the less quantity of water, and according to the rainfall we have to apply the water and according to the requirement of the plant. Harvesting and post harvest technology. Harvest the crop at a appropriate physiological maturity. When it reaches to the appropriate physiological maturity, that time we will go for harvesting. The stage at which the external and internal characteristics of the fruit allow. The normal ripening after harvest. Normally it will ripe after harvest. This applies only for the vegetable and fruits. So normally some crops, meaning cereals, we harvest when they are complete in ripening stage. But in case of some fruits and vegetables, we will harvest the unripe, and after harvesting they will ripe. Consideration in harvesting. When we go for harvesting, we have to minimize the mechanical injuries. So sometime when we go for harvesting, there is a chance of some mechanical injuries. So there is a very less mechanical injuries. Avoid the high temperature. When the temperature is more, means in case of afternoon time, when the temperature is very high, that time we will not go for harvesting. The harvesting time normally we will prefer in case of evening time or early morning time, so the temperature is less, so that we can store them for the longer period of the time. Avoid the exposure to the direct sunlight. Means after just harvest, we will not expose to the fruits and vegetable direct to the sunlight, because it will reduce the moisture content of that particular fruits. Minimize the contact with the soil. So after harvesting, we will maintain that it will not come in contact with the soil, because if it come in contact with the soil, there is a risk of some disease and pest. Harvest during the dry period. Dry period means evening time or morning time we will go for harvesting. When the hot sun is there, that time we will not go for harvesting. If shade is there, then only we will go for harvesting. Maturity indices. Fruit and fruit vegetables. The fully development of the aroma and flavor, better taste and appearance. When the fully development of aroma and flavor, and when it develop the better taste and appearance, that time we will go for harvesting. Maximum respiratory substrate for the slower the nations. We will use the maximum respiratory substrate for the slow senescence. Thicker cuticle for the lesser transpiration resistance to the mechanical stress. So whatever that we have to select, it is resistant to the mechanical stress and difficult entry of microorganisms, and we will reduce the attack of microorganisms. Genetic purity. We have to maintain the genetic purity. It is free from the wild seed, other crop seeds or inert matter. No mixture of other wild seed mixture is not there. Clean, it is completely in clean stage. Reach to the physiological maturity. When it is reached to the physiological maturity, that time we will go for harvesting. Free from the pest occurrence. Means whatever the seeds we have to select, it is free from the pest occurrence, disease occurrence. Can be stored and keep. Means whatever we select, it can be, we can store it and we can keep it. Uniform size and shape. So whatever we select, it is uniform in size and shape is uniform. Maturity indices. So there is a different maturity indices for the different vegetables, like radish and carrot. The large enough and crispy. It will mature in 50 days after sowing. When they are large and crispy, they will mature in 50 days after sowing. Onion and garlic. Tops beginning to dry out and topples down. Means the 50% neck fall is there in onion. A 50% neck will be start, means leaf will be start drying and will be fall down. It is 120 days after sowing we have to go for in onion and garlic. Ginger, large enough 180 days after sowing. So in ginger, the maturity index means 180 days after sowing, we will go for harvesting. Green onion, the leaves are broad, best and longest. 60 days after harvesting, we will go for green onion. In beans, cowpea, the well-filled pods that are beginning to lose their greenest. In 100 days after transplanting, we will go for harvesting in beans and cowpea. So these are the maturity indices of different crops. In red is carrot, onion. In tomato, when we go for harvesting, when the color of the tomato turns into the complete in red color, that time we will go for harvesting. In bhindi, when the bhindi is tender, normally for vegetable purpose, when it is tender and when it is break, means it will, the tip of the bhindi is easily break, so that time we will go for harvesting. Okra, the tips can be snapped easily, means 120 days after sowing. So the tip of the okra will be break easily, that time we will go for harvesting. Upo or patola, the thumbnails can still penetrate the flesh readily. It will take 180 days after planting, we will go for harvesting. Eggplant and cucumber. Eggplant, cucumber, the over mature if the dull in color. If the color is dull in color, means they are over mature. It will take 150 days after planting in eggplant. Sweet corn, 70 days after planting, 70 days after sowing, we will go for harvesting. Execute the milky shape when thumbnails penetrate. When we nail the thumbnails in that, it will execute the milky shape. So that time we can say it is ready for harvesting. It will take us 70 days after sowing. Sweet pepper, deep green color turning into the dull or red color. When the deep, it take 180 days after sowing, we will go for harvesting in sweet pepper. The color is changed into the yellow color. Musk melon, easily separated from the vine with the slight twist, leaving clean cavity. It will take the 100 days after sowing. 100 days after sowing, the musk melon are ready for harvesting. Just we will twist that and the cavity, twist that and we can harvest. Chito, pods are ready for harvesting when it turns into the brown color. To harvest the crop by priming and hand picking the dried pods into the morning when the leaves and pods are dried in 120 days after planting. So normally 120 days after planting we will go for harvesting in sito. In the when the leaves are turns into the color of the leaves will be changed and the pods will start complete development. Onion and garlic, the full development of papery scale, full development of papery scale, greater resistance to the transpiration. When the 50 to 70% leaves of the onion will be fall down, it is called as neck in small in color. 50% leaf are fall down. In garlic, when the leaves of garlic turns into the yellow and bulb, the leaves and bulb are turns start into the yellow color, that time we will go for harvesting. Tomato, pink color start to show at blossom end. For nearly market, fruits are mature green. For distance market, seed slipping when the fruits is cut and cut or the green turning into the pink color. Normally tomato are harvested 120 days after sowing. So tomato normally harvested in the different according to the market. For near market, we will harvest when it is turns into the pink color. Then for distance market, we will harvest when it is in somewhat reddish in color, when it turns into the red in color, and for sleeping, and it will take 120 days after sowing. Cauliflower, when the curd is compact, creamy white in color, means 75 days after sowing. Curd is compact, creamy white in color, 75 days after sowing, we will go for harvesting. Honeydew in melon, green in color 100 days after planting. Like in case of watermelon, we will tip the watermelon. If the dull sound will come, means it is ready for harvesting. If metallic sound will come, means it is not ready for harvesting. Muskmelon, the dull hollow sound when tapped and the leaves will start drying. It is 100 days after planting, we will go for harvesting in melons, in muskmelon. Cabbage, the compact head and thicker cuticle for the greater resistance to the mechanical stress and lesser transpiration. Cabbage, when the head is compact, that time we will go for harvesting. It will take 85 days after sowing for harvesting. Tuber and root crops, the fully development of skin. When the skin is completely developed, that time we will harvest the root crops for the greater resistance to the mechanical stress and lesser transpiration. Means when they are resistant to the mechanical stress and the transpiration rate is less, that time we will go for harvesting of tuber and root crop. Seed production technology. The certified seed of vegetables are expensive. However, their purity is guaranteed. For the commercial scale production using certified seeds, every planting season is more profitable. In commercial scale production, we can use the certified seeds for every planting season for more profit. For home garden, it is advisable to produce your own planting material from the certified seeds. If we are going for the home garden, then we can prepare the our own planting materials for the certified seeds. Seed drying, cleaning and treatment. Sun drying. So sun drying, normally drying we use the sun drying. The manual sealing with the use of hand. Manually we have to seal them, and we will go for sun drying, and manually we have to seal them. Seed cleaning. Clean the seed manually by winnowing. With the help of winnowing, we will clean the seeds. It is free from the inert matter and all. Remove the damaged and pest infected seeds. So whatever the seeds we have to select, they are free from the, if any seeds which are damaged during the harvesting or it is infected by the any pest, that seeds we have to remove. After cleaning, sun drying to a moisture content of 12%. Means after cleaning, we have to go for sun drying. And the time of sun drying is when the moisture content is 12%, till that we will go for drying. Fungal infection is most common problem from the improper seed drying. If we not go for proper seed drying, so there is attack of fungal infection. Treat the seed with recommended insecticides and fungicides to control the stored product pest. So we have to treat the seeds with insecticide or fungicide to control the stored product pest. So sometimes when we go for storage of seeds, there is a chance of some attack of some stored pest. So to control that, we will go for treatment with insecticide or fungicide. How to produce good seeds? Follow the steps to minimize the degeneration of the varieties. Select a site for the seed production, preferably at the center of the field. So whenever we select the site, it will be in middle of the field. The plant one seed per hill following the at the recommended distance. Means we will plant only one seed per hill. Means one place only we plant one seed by recommendation of the particular spacing, and we will recommend a cultural management practices. Whatever the cultural management practices are there, like preparation of the field, sowing of the seeds, then weeding, irrigation, fertilizer application, that everything, all cultural practice we have to follow when we go for seed production. Evaluate the performance of each hill as to productive and reaction to the insect pest and disease. So after sowing of the seeds, we have to check the every seeds and every plants. We check whether it is infected by the any insect pest or any disease. Rock out the hills that are not productive, susceptible to insect pest and disease, and not true to type. Means rock out means any disease are there, any weeds are there that we have to remove, and the whatever the plants we have to select, it is not susceptible to any insect pest and disease, and it is not true to type. True to type means whatever the plants we are growing, it is not same to that plant. Same is there, then again if we grow, the quality will be reduced. If they in two type, what will happen? The quality of the produce will be reduced day by day. Use only the harvest from the first and second priming of the for the seed purpose. Normally we harvest only first and second time for the seed purpose. Sun dry harvested pods for 2 to 3 days. After harvesting, we will go for sun drying for 2 to 3 days, but not too long, means not for so long, only for 2 to 3 days. 8 to 10 a.m. and 3 to 4 p.m. is the time of harvesting. Sun drying is 8 to 10 a.m. for 3 to 4 p.m. Sell the pod after drying. After drying, we will sell the pods. Separate the abnormal and deformed seeds from the good ones. We will separate the abnormal and deformed seeds from the good ones. Dry the good seeds until they have reached to the 8 to 12% moisture content. We will go for drying of the seed till they reach to the 8 to 12% moisture content. Till that, we will go for drying of the seed. Treat the seed with recommended insecticide to kill the minute larva of beans. We will. So after that, we will go for treatment of the seeds with the insecticide, because there is attack of larvae in the seeds. So to control that, we will go for seed treatment. If the fruits of hot pepper are available, the ripe fruits mix with the seed before drying. If the seeds of hot pepper are available, the mix the ripe seed and mix with the seeds before drying. Before drying, we will mix into the ripe seed and then we will go for drying. Treat the seed with fungicide to prevent the seed borne drying. To control the seed borne disease, we will treat the seeds with the fungicides. Store the seeds in a glass jar, plastic bag, cotton or nylon net. Any susceptible containers, we not use the any susceptible containers. We will store the seeds into the glass jar, plastic bag or cotton. Fill at least 10% of the containers with charcoal as a desiccant. We will fill it by the 10% charcoal. Label the seed and keep in dry and safe pallets. Desiccant means it will absorb the moisture content, charcoal. So we will keep the charcoal 10%, so it will absorb the moisture. After that, we will go for labeling of the seed and we will keep into the dry and safe pallets. Botanical seed treatment include cacawort and garlic wine to control the weevil of the seed. So we can use the garlic wine or cacawort we use to control the weevil of the seed. Required humidity and temperature for long-term storage. The temperature is not exist 10 degrees centigrade with RH is not exist 50%. Means 10 degrees centigrade temperature and relative humidity is 50% for long-term storage. For storage up to 1 year, the temperature should not be exist 25. So if you are going for 1 year storage, then the temperature will not more than 25 degrees centigrade and the relative humidity is 50%. So if long-term storage, we can store 10 degrees centigrade, and for 1 year we can store this for 25 degrees centigrade temperature, but the relative humidity is not more than 50%. If there are not possible, keep the seed in coolest and driest place. If these are not possible, then keep the seed in coolest and dry place using the calcium chloride or silica gel. We can use the calcium chloride or silica gel to remove the moisture from the atmosphere in the containers. Genetic factor storage potential varies among the varieties. So genetic factors like climatic factors, genetic factors, they are varies from the varieties they are present inside the seeds. So they are mainly controlled by the genes. So they are various, and climatic factors are different. Climatic factors like light, exposed the fruit or exposed to the sunlight are generally sweeter, mature faster than the said fruits. Some fruits, if they are exposed to the sunlight, they will mature faster and they have more sweets as compared to the normal. Relative humidity. High RH favors the disease occurrence. If the relative humidity, more relative humidity is there, then there is a more attack of disease. Respiration. The commodities with high respiration rate deteriorate fast. If the respiration rate will be fast, the commodity will be deteriorate fast. Thinning. To improve the fruit quality, we will go for fruit thinning. So in one bunch only, if the number of fruits are more, then the quality of the fruits will be reduced and the size of the fruits will be small. So we will go for thinning. We will remove the some fruits and we will allow only some fruits to grow. So the quality will be good. How to prepare the seed of cabbage, peas, cauliflower and okra? Harvest the crop which reaches to the maturity. When crop is reached to the maturity, that time we will go for harvesting. Separate the seed from the pulp using your hand. With the happy hand only we will remove the pulp and air dry and clean by the winnowing. Then we go for air drying and then we go for cleaning of the seeds. Remove the undesirable seeds free from the pest and disease. Whatever the undesirable seeds is there, that we have to remove. Whatever the seeds we have to select, they are free from the pest and disease. Let it dry for 20% MC before keeping to the seeds. Means we will go for drying till it contain the moisture content is 20%. Till that we will go for drying before we keep the seeds for storage. For tomato, harvest the fully mature tomato. For tomato seed production, we will harvest the complete red color fully ripe tomato. Leave it for the 2 days. 2 days we will keep that tomato. Slice the seed into two and squeeze. After 2 to 3 days fermentation, separate the seeds from the pulp using the strainers. With the help of strainer, we can separate the seeds. We will squeeze the seeds and we will take the seeds from the pulp. Let it dry. Normally we will go for air drying and the temperature sun drying up to the 10. When the moisture content will be 10%, till that we will go for drying of the tomato seeds. Squash, eggplant and empleia. We will harvest the fully matured crop. Means in squash and eggplant, we harvest the fully developed matured crop we have to harvest. After that, separate the seeds from the pulp using knife. With the help of knife, we will separate the seeds from the pulp, get the seeds and air dry up to the 10% moisture content. Till the moisture content will be 10%, till that we will go for drying and then we remove the undesired seeds. If some seeds they are affected when we go for using the knife, if seeds are damaged, so this type seeds we have to remove. And the moisture content will be 10%. We have to maintain the moisture content 10% and remove the undesirable seeds. Undesirable means the seeds which are not in use. That seed we have to remove. Some of the seeds of hope plant tentatively in the fall have not come up. They lie stillborn and unrealized. Somewhere in the spring soil decaying, the strongest and best one push up through the leaves and layers of cold, hard resistance right into clear blue air and stand there nectar green dripping. It is always that way with growing the things, never knowing at the start which will make it and which will fail, but the thing to hold fast, to never to lose the faith. Means whenever we go for seed production as a gardener, whenever we go for seed production, we will not lose our hope. Like sometime what will happen, there is attack of some disease, there is attack of some pest. So that time we will not lose our hope. We have to maintain a proper seed, proper spacing we have to maintain, proper package and practice we have to maintain, and we will develop the seeds. Seeds are the major part of the plant. So that's all about today's class. Thank you. Have a good day. Thank you all. Hello?